大家好，我是 Eddie，欢迎来到 ChineseEddieG。Hi guys, this is Eddie. Welcome to my channel. In today's Chinese grammar lesson, we're gonna compare the use of 又 and 在. Let's get started. 我们开始吧。Usually, we can put both 又 and 在 before a verb. However, when you use 又, that means the action or the situation has already happened. That means the recurrence has already happened. If you use 在, that means the recurrence has not happened yet, but you want to do it again. So, to put it in a simpler way, when you use 又, that means you did something, and then you did that thing again. And both actions or both situations have already happened. Meanwhile, when you use 在, that means you did something, but you want to do that thing once more or more times. This time, you use 在. Now, to give you a better understanding, let's check the sentences, example sentences on our textbook. So first, four sentences are the use of 又. Let's get started. Number one, 上个星期我买了一条裤子。昨天又买了一条。Last week, I've already bought a pair of pants. Yesterday, I bought another pair. 上个星期我买了一条裤子。昨天又买了一条。上个星期我买了一条裤子。昨天又买了一条。Let's break down the sentence. 上个 means last. 个 is a measure word. 星期 week. 我买了 I bought. 买 means to buy. 了 indicates the action has happened. 买了 means past tense.Or present perfect. 一条 one. So 条 here is just a measure word for pants. However, it is not only for pants. It could be for other items. Let's say a scarf. You can say 一条围巾一条围巾 or a necklace. 一条项链一条项链 So you can sum up. If you see something long, kind of long, you can use 条 as a measure word because think about it, 裤子, it has a certain length, right? It's not short, it's very long. The necklace is long, you know, the shape, and a scarf, of course, is long. Then 条 is a measure word for those items. 昨天, yesterday, 又 means again, it's our grammar point of today.买了 bought 一条 one. You can actually add 裤子 So you say 昨天又买了一条裤子 But it's not really necessary because we know we're talking about pants. That's why the sentence omit pants, this phrase. Second one, 第二句你上午已经喝了一杯咖啡，下午怎么又喝了一杯 ？You already had a cup of coffee this morning. Why did you drink another cup in the afternoon? So both of these actions have happened. That's why we use 又 in the second clause, right? Just make sure about that point.你上午已经喝了一杯咖啡，下午怎么又喝了一杯？你上午已经喝了一杯咖啡，下午怎么又喝了一杯 ？Let's break down the sentence. 你 you 上午 this morning. Well, usually when you say this morning, it would be 今天。上午 because in this context, 今天 would be this, 上午 would be morning, So 今天上午, that's this morning. However, in this context, you don't necessarily have to say 今天上午. So the sentence omit 今天, the concept. It just says 你上午. 已经 means already. 喝了, drank. Remember, 了 indicates something has already happened. 喝了. 一杯, one. 杯 is a measure word for drinks. If it's a cup, then you use 杯 or glass, cups or glasses. You can say 杯. 咖啡, it sounds very like coffee, correct? Then it's coffee. 咖啡. 下午, afternoon. Or you can understand it as this afternoon, as we talked about this context. 怎么? 怎么 means how come or why. 又 means again. 喝了, drank. 一杯, a cup, means a cup of coffee. Number three. 小刚, 你前天迟到, 昨天迟到, 今天怎么又迟到了? 小刚, you were late 2 days ago. And you were late yesterday. How come you were late again? In this sentence, it talks about three situations. They are respectively the day before yesterday, yesterday, and today. However, all the actions have already, completed. So that's why we use 又, but not 在. Just want to be clear about that. 小刚, 你前天迟到, 昨天迟到, 今天怎么又迟到了? 小刚, 你前天迟到, 昨天迟到, 今天怎么又迟到了? Let's break down the sentence. 小刚, that's just a person's name and it sounds like a boy. 刚, this word alone means steel as a material. So I guess the boy's parents want their son to be tough like steel, right? And it's a good meaning for a boy's name. 小刚, 你, you, 前天, the day before yesterday, or you could think it as 2 days ago. 前天, that's how Chinese people talk about 2 years ago. But you can also say 两天前. If you say 两天前, literally is 2 days ago, right? But the alternative way to talk about 2 years, like 2 days ago, would be 前天, which literally means the day before yesterday. 迟到 was late, be late. 昨天, yesterday. 迟到, late. 今天, today. 怎么? How come or why? 又 means again. 迟到了 means was late. So you might wonder why in this sentence it doesn't add 了 after 迟到 in each clause, right? So for example, the sentence could be 小刚，你前天迟到了，昨天迟到了。You see, I add 了, but the sentence doesn't have 了 for the second and the third clause. That's because, in spoken Chinese, we want to make the sentence sounds neat and short and smart, and then we just omit 了 because we only need to add 了 at the last 迟到, right? In the last clause, you see 迟到了, so it's not necessary to put 了 after every 迟到. If you omit 了, it actually makes you sound even smarter or natural, more natural. But if you insist adding 了 after every 迟到, it's also correct. Yeah, I can't say you're wrong. Number four, 第四句. 我昨天看了一个电影，今天又看了一个。I watched a movie yesterday, and I watched one again. So these two actions have both happened. That's why we use 又, but not 在, okay? 我昨天看了一个电影,今天又看了一个。Let's break down the sentence. 我昨天, yesterday, 看了, watched, that's past tense, 一个, one, 电影, movie, 今天, today, 又, again, 看了, watched, 一个, one. Something interesting here is that 一个电影 sounds fine. But you know what measure word will make you sound even smarter? Like, oh my god, you sound like a Chinese. And then you use 一部电影. 部 is the most accurate measure word for a movie or TV series. Okay, 一部电影. 我昨天看了一部电影. Yeah, that's the alternative way to say the sentence. Now let's move on to the use of 在, and let's check the sentences out. Number 5. 你只吃了一点饭,再吃一点吧. You've only had a little rice. Please have more. Now in this sentence, you notice in the first clause, the action has finished. However, the second clause hasn't. That's why we use 在, because the recurrence of the second action hasn't finished. It doesn't even happen. So we use 在, which means you want to do it more or you want to do it more times.
你只吃了一点饭,再吃一点吧。你只吃了一点饭,再吃一点吧。
Let's break down the sentence. 你, you, 只, only, 吃了, ate, or have eaten. 一点 means a little. And as a person, once again, I'm going to highlight it. I am from the south. I'm a southern cutie. I don't use R a lot. I would say 一点, and then 一点饭, a little rice, 一点饭. 饭 means rice. 再吃 means eat more. 一点 means a little. So eat a little more. 把, it should be at the end of a sentence and meaning a suggestion. Number 6.
家里只有一个面包了。我们再买一些吧。There's
only one bread at home. Let's go and buy some more.
家里只有一个面包了。我们再买一些吧。家里只有一个面包了。我们再买一些吧。Let's
break down the sentence.
家里, at home. 家 is home.
里 means in or inside. So you don't have to translate it literally. Just understand it as at home.
只有, only has, or only have. 一个, one. 面包, bread.
And you don't have to translate 了 or understand it separately in the sentence. You can just treat 只有, le as a structure, like only has or only have. 只有, le.
我们, we, 在,
here means more because 买 means buy. So 再买 means buy more, buy again. Because, you know, in the second clause, the action hasn't happened. So that's why we use 在 instead of 有. That's the comparison. That's the whole point in this lesson.
一些 means a few or some.
把 at the end of the sentence, indicating a suggestion.
我们再买一些吧.
Just like at the beginning of every class of EddieG, I will say, let's get started.
我们开始吧. It's the same. I suggest let's get started. Ba means suggestion. Number 7. 那个饭馆我昨天去了一次,明天还想再去一次.
I went to that restaurant once yesterday, and today I want to go there again.
那个饭馆我昨天去了一次,明天还想再去一次. 那个饭馆我昨天去了一次。明天还想再去一次。
Let's break down the sentence.
那个 that 饭
馆 restaurant, but I prefer to say 餐馆餐馆 I guess it's a southern thing to say 餐馆 because 饭馆 sounds more like what people from north would say, I guess.
我 I 昨天
yesterday.
去了,
went,
一次,
once, because 次 means times, 一次 means once. And therefore, you can guess how to say twice, three times, four times. You just need to say the number plus 次, like 两次, 三次, 四次, and etc.
明天,
tomorrow,
还,
also, 还 means also.
想
want, also want.
再去
go more, or go again.
再去一次
one time or once.
明天还想再去一次
Tomorrow also want to go there once again. And because the action hasn't happened, that's why we use 再 instead of 又, okay? Last sentence.
昨天去看了看，今天又去看了看，明天还要再去看看。
Yesterday, I went to check it. Today, I went to check it again. Tomorrow, I will go check it again. This is a stupid sentence. I don't even know what this guy wants to check. But it's just an example to discuss the grammar.
昨天去看了看，今天又去看了看，明天还要再去看看。
Let's break down the sentence.
昨天
yesterday,
去
means go, but since the action has happened, we translate it as went.
昨天去
okay, yesterday went.
看了看，看
means to look, you know, to check here, you know, maybe he wants to...check something, you know, check or look,
看.
But when you say 看了看, it's actually a sentence structure, means to take a look,
看了看.
And usually if you use the sentence structure, it means the action actually is short. That's why I use the English translation, take a look, okay?
昨天去看了看,
yesterday I went to take a look.
今天
Today,
又去
went again, and be careful. In the second clause, it uses 又 instead of 在. That's because the action has happened, has finished.
明天
tomorrow,
还要
还 means also, 要 means will,
还要
will go,
再去看看再去。
Go again, go once more.
明天还要再去看看。
Because in this clause, the action hasn't happened. That's why we use 再 instead of 又。
看看
is just another way to say
看一看。
Okay, 看一看 means to take a look, but 看看 also means to take a look. So when you say two verbs,together, like you say it twice, right?
看看,
look, look. That means you take a look. It's a short action. However, in the first two clauses, it is not
看一看.
Instead, it is 看了看. You know, 了 indicates something has already happened, like a completion of action. That's why it is 了, not 已. If you say 看一看, that means you are going to take a look. 看一看. That's the difference. Alright, that's the end of our lesson today. And again, we have practice for you to review what we learned today. There are three unfinished sentences, and your goal is to choose either 又 or 在 to fill up the blanks. Yes, so if you have any confusion, leave a comment. And if you want to do the exercise, you can also do it down below at the comment section, and I will check your answer to tell you whether it's correct or wrong. 好了，这就是我们今天的课。Alright guys, that is all for today's lesson. 我们下次见。See you guys next time. Bye bye.